Hello students, in this video we will see the differences between a true solution, colloids and suspension. So let's see how they are differ from each other. Now before we start, you should keep one example of each in your mind. For solution we can take the example of sugar solution, for colloid we can take the example of milk, and for suspension sand and water. So first parameter is stability. Stability means when we make solution and keep it for some time, what will happen to it? So in first condition, that is true solutions are stable, means now we will keep the solution, it will remain as it is. In colloid it is also stable, but in suspension it is unstable. Why? Because when we stir sand in water, when we make the solution, that is actually suspension. So क्या होता है कि थोड़ी देर बाद आप देखेंगे कि सैंड पार्टिकल्स नीचे बैठ गए हैं, और बहुत जो लाइटर सैंड पार्टिकल्स दे आर स्टिल मूविंग इन द वाटर, मीन्स दे आर नॉट स्टेबल, पार्टिकल्स सेपरेट हो जाते हैं. सो दैट इज अनस्टेबिलिटी. सो सस्पेंशन इज अनस्टेबल. नाउ सेकेंड इज टाइप ऑफ मिक्सचर. सेकेंड पैरामीटर टाइप ऑफ मिक्सचर. सो सॉल्यूशंस आर होमोजेनस इन नेचर. कोलॉइड्स आर इन अपीयरेंस दे आर होमोजेनस, बट actually in composition they are heterogeneous. And suspension, they are heterogeneous, means they are not even in whole. Now third is size of particles. So size of particles in solution is very small, that is less than 1 nanometer. 1 nanometer, that is equal to 10^-9 meters. So very small particles in size. And when we talk about colloids, the particles of size lies between 1 to 100 nanometer in diameter. And when we talk about suspension, so particle size is bigger, that is more than 100 nanometer. So they are big enough. Now fourth point is filtration. When we filter any solution, the particles of that solution can't be separated by filter paper. Keep the examples in mind so that you can easily understand. In colloids, particles, when we filter it, particles again cannot be separated by filter paper. But when we filter a suspension, the particles can be separated by filter paper. Now in solution, as the particle size is very small, they do not scatter light. But in colloids, the particles are big enough to scatter light, means they show Tyndall effect. Again in suspension, the particles are big enough to scatter light, so they also show Tyndall effect. Now last parameter is, can we see the particles of these three by naked eye? So for first, that is solution, the particles of the solution cannot be seen by naked eyes. Same goes with colloids. The particles of colloids also cannot be seen by naked eyes. But when we talk about suspension, the particles of suspension can be seen by naked eyes. So main thing is that if you keep the examples for solution, colloid and suspension each in your mind, it is easy to understand that how they are differ from each other.